Hi everyone, it's June 30th and it's a hot day in Edmonton today, and I'm going to record this video for the poultry science meeting, which is a virtual meeting in 2021. In this video, I'm going to talk about metabolomics, biomarkers of sexual development in broiler breeders. So in order for broiler breeders to come to sexual maturity, they need to reach some thresholds in terms of body weight, body composition, frame size, metabolic status, and hypothalamic maturity. Several sites are involved in this process, including hypothalamus and pituitary, ovaries, liver, fat, and muscle. Looking at the hypothalamus pituitary gonad axis, or we can call it HPG axis or reproductive axis, it starts off the hypothalamus by secretion of CGNRH, or chicken gonadotropin releasing hormone. And it ends up at the ovary levels by secretion of estradiol and progesterone. Several factors can affect the activation of the HPG axis. Some of them are environmental factors, for example, light, nutrition, temperature, and some of them are intrinsic factors, for example, metabolic status of the bird. And growth trajectory of bird and body composition can affect metabolic status, and thereby they can affect activation of the HPG axis. You may have seen some laying birds, especially laying pullets, came to sexual maturity even before photostimulation. And in fact, it shows the effect of metabolic status on the activation of the reproductive axis. And we have seen it in broiler breeders as well. In this study, we had some ad libitum birds. They came to lay around 2 weeks before photostimulation. And in fact, it showed how important metabolic status of the bird is, and it can activate the reproductive axis even before photostimulation. So our objectives in this study were to evaluate the effect of maturity on plasma metabolome dynamics. We looked at the differential metabolites during the pullet to hen transition period. And also we wanted to provide potential biomarkers for predicting sexual development in broiler breeders. Why? In fact, if farmers can detect the differential metabolites during the pullet to hen transition period, they can evaluate their broiler breeders in terms of sexual development status. And based on that, they can see how their management has worked and what changes they might need to implement on their system. So actually, the ultimate goal is to develop a point of care device similar to a glucometer. And by that, actually we can measure a broiler breeder plasma metabolome in real time at the flock level and in a matter of minutes. So what we did, we created 10 growth trajectories. The basic one was the ROS708 target body weight, and we increased prepubertal and pubertal body weight gain from 2.5 all the way to 22.5% by 2.5% incremental. We did that using the triphasic Gompertz growth model, and by doing this, actually, we created a range for age at first egg to study the metabolic status during the pullet to hen transition period. So looking at the experimental design, we assigned 30 birds to one of the 10 growth trajectories, and also we assigned the 6 birds to an unrestricted group, or let's say ad libitum one. We implemented growth trajectories using a precision feeding system that you can see in this picture. Actually, a precision feeding system is a machine that gives birds access to the feed based on their real-time body weight. If their real-time body weight is less than target body weight, the machine will let them eat. Otherwise, it will kick them out of station gently. We collected blood from 18 to 26 weeks of age by 2 weeks intervals. And we used age at first egg to group the birds into pullet or hens based on their status at the blood collection date. We used direct injection liquid chromatography tandem mass spectrometry at the University of Alberta to measure broiler breeder plasma metabolome. For the statistical analysis after normalization of data, we used univariate analysis methods for the exploratory data analysis, for example, fold change analysis, t-test, volcano plot, and we used PCA, PLSDA, and OPLSDA methods to recognize the patterns of metabolites in pullets or hens. We used VIP score to define and to detect the significantly differential metabolites between two groups. And we used rock curve analysis to evaluate the performance of biomarkers. And our pathway analysis was done based on KEG or Kyoto Encyclopedia of Genes and Genomes. We used Metaboloanalyst 5 software to analyze our data. Looking at the PCA and OPLSDA graphs, we can see there was a clear separation between metabolites between hens and the pullets group. We used VIP scores to detect the differential metabolites between pullets and hens. And here you can see, for example, carnitine was high in hens, but on the other hand, for example, citric acid was high in pullets. And looking at the rock curve analysis, we got 96.5% for the area under the curve, and it shows a good performance of biomarkers models. We did pathway analysis of differential metabolites between the pullets and hens groups. And as you can see in this picture, the first and most important pathway was related to the glycerophospholipid metabolism. The second important one was related to citrate cycle or TCA cycle, or let's say Krebs cycle. And the third one was related to glycosylate and dicarboxylate metabolism. So in fact, main metabolic pathways involved in the transition of a pullet to hen are related to lipid, energy, and amino acids metabolism. So in conclusion for this study, we found some potential biomarkers of pullet to hen transition. We saw that carnitine metabolites are upregulated during the transition of a pullet to hen, because you know carnitine is involved in the mitochondrial oxidation of fatty acids, and in fact carnitine is carrying the activated fatty acids into the mitochondria to involve them in the beta oxidation process. And also, colin metabolites were upregulated during the pullet to hen transition period because they are involved in egg yolk precursor synthesis. But on the other hand, we saw plasma citric acid was downregulated due to increase in lipogenesis in the liver at the cost of glycolysis. As you can see, citric acid or citrate is one of the substrate or let's say middle guys in Krebs cycle. And by downregulation of that, it means that TCA cycle was downregulated. It means that glucose, instead of going to the Krebs cycle to be metabolized, it went to the lipogenesis pathway to actually create fat and accumulate it. And as we showed, it's important for the egg yolk precursor synthesis as well. I'm going to thank our funders and thank you for your attention and good luck.